Hi, welcome to Coursera's Instrumental Analysis class. I'm going to be taking you through a couple of examples that help you practice what we've learned about retention time, especially the quantitative treatment of retention time. So there's a couple of different formulas I highlight here, and some of the concepts you're going to have to be juggling as you think about both conceptually and mathematically retention times in chromatography. First of all, there's of course K-bar, which is our partition coefficient, which tells us where does an analyte want to be? Does it want to be in the stationary phase or does it want to be in the mobile phase? And of course, there's the equivolume piece, which is just MS over M sub M. But if you've also got to take volume into account, you've got to remember that. Then there's little k, which is our capacity factor, which is a measure of how long something takes to go through the column. Big capacity factors mean it takes a long time. Small capacity factors means it went through really fast. And finally, the relationship between capacity factor and partition coefficient, which we're going to use to sort of explore and understand why things move through the column the way they do. Okay, so let's go through some practice finding little k. You can read this and stop the video now if you want, and just apply pretty much the definitions of capacity factor to this problem. It's pretty straightforward, so don't think too much. Okay, so here's how we do it. So it's pretty straightforward. You take benzene. To get the adjusted retention time, it's just the retention time that something comes out at subtracted from the Tm. It's what I was calling in the old lecture the time you spend in the stationary phase. To get little k, you take that adjusted retention time and you divide it by T sub m. So the capacity factor for the benzene is almost 5. So basically it took 5 mobile phase units to get through the column. The reason that's a useful way of conveying retention time is it sort of factors out issues that might be related to things like flow rates. Toluene, on the other hand, took 291, took longer to get through the column, and so it has a little k that's larger, right around 7. So pretty straightforward application of the definition of capacity factors, or little k. Okay, why don't you stop the video and try to do this one? It's very similar. But to get the little k, again, it's just the time it takes, it's spent in the stationary phase, which is the retention time minus the mobile phase time divided by the mobile phase time. So the fraction of the time the solute was in the mobile phase is just actually very straightforward. It's the T sub M divided by T sub R, or 0.33 in this case. Little k and big k are just related by this expression, so you can calculate the partition coefficient very easily once you know the capacity factor. And in this case, it's 20. And so that's kind of interesting. Because the solute came through in 9 minutes, but it had a 20 partition coefficient. So you'd think that it'd spend a lot of time in the stationary phase. But remember that the volume is very different. And so that's going to pull a lot of it out so that it spends time also in the mobile phase. Okay, here's two conceptual questions that you might also want to stop and try to solve. So if you increase the partition coefficient between the stationary and mobile phase, what happens to little k? What happens to the retention time? Well, if you have an analyte that wants to spend more time in the stationary phase, all things being equal, then the capacity factor is going to increase. It's going to be hanging out in the stationary phase. It's not going to be moving with the mobile phase. So little k gets large and the retention time gets large. So both increase. If you increase the volume of the stationary phase, what happens to little k? Now, remember, the volume of the stationary phase is going to push stuff in. So if you have more volume of the stationary phase, then in effect, you're going to be driving material into the stationary phase, all things being equal, because it's trying to keep concentration the same. So if the volume suddenly gets bigger, it's got to pull more molecules in to stay at the same concentration. So what that means is if you increase the volume of the stationary phase, you're going to be pulling material into the stationary phase, assuming it's in dynamic equilibrium. And so that's actually going to make little k also big and the retention time big. And so, okay, this last example is kind of interesting because it just requires some geometric analysis. So this actually refers back to the first example, not the one we just did. In this example, you're being asked to estimate the partition coefficient for benzene between the stationary and mobile phases, and you're given a lot of geometric information. So really what this problem is boiling down to is doing a volume calculation. So instead of telling you that the mobile phase has 10 times more volume than the stationary phase, I'm asking you to calculate that. And it gives me a chance to briefly speak about the geometry of chromatography columns. In gas phase chromatography in particular, the open tube is a very, very common format, or the capillary tube. So this is a really realistic geometry. More commonly in liquid, you're going to see packed bed columns, which look very different, or sometimes you'll see solid core columns as well in GC. But in any case, this problem boils down to first calculating the ratio of the volume in the stationary phase to the volume in the mobile phase, and then applying the same equations that we have in the last few problems. So let's get started. So the volume in the mobile phase is going to be the length of the cylinder times pi r squared. But remember that r in this case is half of that internal diameter. And since I had to take into account the 1 micron thick stationary phase, that's going to give me 124 microns squared for the radius. And so there I have it with L, which I don't know. Then I do the stationary phase calculation. That's a little different. It's kind of the difference between the inner diameter and then the diameter that I think is there at 250. I didn't say that right, but hopefully you can draw it up and see what I mean. Anyhow, the stationary phase volume is much, much, much smaller, of course, than the mobile phase. The stationary phase, by the way, is that black material. So we know from the last example that little k is 5. So right away, we have the expression little k is equal to big K times the ratio of these two phases. And that's why not knowing L is not a problem, because L will cancel. When I plug all that in, I get a partition of 308. I hope you were able to follow those examples. They'll be very similar ones on your problem sets and on the quizzes. Thanks so much. See you next time.